since Douglas Carswell made political history in Clacton for the UK Independence Party. This week, some more good news for the party in Essex. A group of independent councillors on Canvey Island say they'll support UKIP candidate at the next election in Castle Point. The details now from Tom Barton.
If Jamie Huntman doesn't look like a typical politician, it's because he insists he doesn't feel like one either. But the wood merchant and UKIP councillor hopes to find himself in Westminster after next May's general election.
You didn't have to go into politics. You could have stayed as a timber merchant. What was it that made you decide to make the leap into being a politician?
Well, I still take issue with that because, I'll always be a timber merchant. But because I saw the damage it was doing to me and other people like me. I've always worked relatively hard. I've always put money in. I've never taken anything out. I've always tried to employ local people. I've taken on apprentices. I've done all these things. And all I've heard back in the 20-odd years I've been doing this is platitudes.
And if winning friends is an important part of the political game, Jamie Huntman has shown he knows how to play.
I mean, when you think of it, you know, your son moved to New Zealand because he felt depressed in his country.
The Canvey Island Independent Party, which has a near political monopoly on the island, has said it will back him in next May's general election. In return, UKIP have pledged not to contest any borough council seats on Canvey.
Farage has come along and people connect to him because he sounds like the guy in the street. And, you know, I think that's why we get support, because we are the guy in the street. You know, we're just ordinary local people decided we would want to make a change. And I think talking to the UKIP guys, they're all just individual, they're working class people who want to help their community. That's why we're going to support them.
Coming off the back of their landslide result in the Clacton by-election, UKIP are in a confident mood, and nowhere more so than in South Essex, where they made gains in the local and European elections earlier this year. They're fighting hard, both here in Castle Point and in the neighbouring constituencies of South Basildon and East Thurrock, and Thurrock itself, a seat which Labour and Conservative sources have told me they are now treating as a three-way marginal. UKIP aren't just hoping to do well in South Essex. Researchers at the University of Nottingham have identified almost two dozen seats in the east of England that would be of interest to the party. All of them have a lot in common: a large number of pensioners, a significant number of people with few or no qualifications, and relatively low levels of immigration. But despite the fact that immigration here is low, the issue remains a concern for diners at Canvey Island's Labworth Cafe.
Well, I think their policies are really what most people have got on their mind these days, I think. Mainly the immigration, I think.
And it isn't just, as I say, I've got a multicultural family, so it isn't anything to do with discrimination in any way. It's just the volume coming and coming and coming.
Well, I think the most of it is Europe and immigration. If you eliminate those two subjects, then I'm not so sure that UKIP have got a great deal to offer.
With a Conservative majority of more than 7,000, winning this seat will be a tough ask. But victory in Castle Point is something UKIP insist could be possible.
Well, at the last election, the Tories had a majority of 7,600. Rebecca Harris beat the former MP, Bob Spink, who had defected from the Tories but didn't fight the seat for UKIP and stayed on as an independent in the Commons. So, does Rebecca Harris believe her seat is under threat from UKIP?
I don't know if under threat is the right word. I know that they've been talking a lot about Castle Point, but at the moment, even though a very important general election is 7 months away, I'm very focused on just working in my constituency, because it's a very busy brief, and I've got really too much to think about than the general election at this stage.
That sounds like a very good answer, but actually, come the general election, you will have needed to have thought about it quite seriously between now and then, won't you?
Well, I'm not into tactics or any of those sort of, you know, political, you know, game playing to work out how you win an election. I'm just going to play a straight bat, frankly, like I did in the last election when I was up against an independent, which is working hard for my community, And hopefully people will recognise I've worked hard and my track record should speak for itself. But I want to put a positive message about the future and about what I want to go on and deliver in Castle Point, and also what I think a Conservative government, a majority Conservative government, can deliver in the next 5 years.
You've got unemployment, which is 15% higher than many parts in the East. You've got half as many people with degrees as in other parts of the region. Do you think that there is a correlation between those kind of statistics in your constituency and the rise of UKIP?
I have a very particular constituency, actually. It's really quite special. It's got a very strong work ethic. These are, I'm tempted to say it's a Thatcherite constituency, which is why I like it so much. It's a strong work ethic. People want to put in and work hard, and they need a government that backs them, and a Conservative government that backs them to say, yes, if you do the right thing,
They do work hard, but actually the average wage there is 20% lower than in the rest of the region. Don't they want a government that actually says, if you work hard, we pay you well?
What we're really working hard on, and the schools and the colleges are really doing a superb job with a huge increase in apprenticeships, is getting the really good, highly skilled, highly qualified jobs, which will make the next generation have so many more opportunities, and those better skilled, better paid jobs that will make their lives more fulfilling. But we've really got to improve education. We've been working very hard on it with some spectacular successes in Castle Point over the last 5 years.
But if I'm somebody who is living on a wage which is 20% below the average for the eastern counties, I am concerned about me today in Castle Point. Yes. I am not concerned with what's going to happen with the next generation.
I think people actually are. They're not so selfish as that, for one thing. But I think a lot of people really understand. They understand the debt we've got ourselves into in this country. They understand how important it is we're getting people back into jobs.
I'm sorry to interrupt you. You're talking about this country. I'm talking about Castle Point. I'm talking about the people who live in your constituency who are underpaid compared with the rest of the region. What can you say to them?
It is a traditionally low-skilled and therefore low-paid area, but with a high work ethic. We need to change that by improving the job offer, and making sure that we are getting new jobs and new businesses and improving our infrastructure so that my residents can get the good, well-paid jobs that I think they deserve and they could achieve in. But it is a long-term project, because you don't change these things overnight.
Why is it, do you think, that you have lower than average immigration into Castle Point, and yet when we asked those people in the cafe what they were worried about, immigration.
It's a national issue. Everyone is saying the same thing. Everyone is worried about immigration at the moment. I don't understand, actually, why you could ever put up candidates against Conservatives, especially strong Eurosceptics like me. It doesn't make any sense at all. Because every time you try and take out a Conservative, you're actually taking us further away from a government that can be that can do all those things they say they want, like getting out of Europe and having a referendum. Every time you reduce the number of Conservatives in Parliament, you are making Ed Miliband's job easy, and we'll end up with either David Cameron or Ed Miliband in Downing Street. So I feel it's completely self-defeating that UKIP put up against strong Eurosceptic Conservatives like myself.
Well, just before we leave UKIP, they've deselected their candidate in the neighbouring seat of South Basildon and East Thurrock. Kerry Smith, the leader of the UKIP group on Basildon Council, fought the seat for the party in 2010, but has now been told he will not be fighting next year.